the FP Bradenton YouTube channel, where we use this medium as a way to keep families connected to the discipleship process here at First Presbyterian Church, downtown Bradenton. We've been talking with families about the church mission. One of the reasons we exist is to cultivate hearts for Jesus from the heart of downtown. And we honestly believe that that starts individually with our heart. We've been talking about this whole idea of being connected to God and having God's hands on our life. Last week, we stuck together as a group and we actually played with, Play-Doh. We played with Play-Doh, adults and kids all together, because the whole point of last week was we need to have God's hands on our life. So we were in Isaiah 64, verse 8, where it says this. It says, "You, O Lord, are our Father. We are the clay. You are the potter. We are all the work of your hand." It is incredibly exciting when we start thinking about our lives as something greater than us and having God actually in control. But it does require a few things that we've got to have a conversation about. One of the things that came out of that conversation is the idea that if, like John 15 says, if we're abiding with him, if we're remaining with him, then somehow we're submitted to the process of having God's hands on our life. So the clay has, again, a very passive role. There's not a lot going on. And one thing that we noticed in the group is everybody that made something completely different. So not one thing was the same, much like in the church. Not every person is going to be exactly the same. We all have different talents. We all have different gifts, etc., etc. We also read some verses in Jeremiah 18 that talked about how sometimes the potter needs a little bit of a redo. Sometimes it's not going exactly right, so the clay gets squished back up, centered on the wheel, and the process kind of starts again, like a reboot. And very often in our lives, we find that that is very much a thing that actually happens, that's actually beneficial to us. At one point, we asked the question, what are some characteristics of God? And everybody answered very nice things about God: loving, patient, merciful, forgiving. And that was really, really good. And then I asked the same question, what are some characteristics of Christians? And interestingly enough, we thought that some of the characteristics of Christians should be the same or similar. And I think the key takeaway from that is not knowing who we are in Christ can be one of the things that kind of stunts our growth. Not knowing what God is making us into. It's not that God needs to tell us the whole story, but in order for us to be fruitful, in order for us to be useful vessels, in order for us to even work together with other people in the church, it is very, very handy to understand that God's hand is on our life and we have to work together to make some things happen, especially when it comes to discipleship and working together in the family. We also got to share some things that maybe we struggle with in regard to submitting or being passive in our relationship with God and letting God fully take control of our lives. And some of us talked about time. Some of us talked about finances. We talked about a lot of things along those lines that honestly we want to be in control of. And sometimes we want to be so in charge that God is almost like with us in a co-pilot position. But that's not the position that God wants to take. He wants to be incredibly active, molding us and making us into exactly what we were designed to be. And for us to be committed to that process is actually a very, very big deal. And it's exciting. It should give us the joy that it talks about in John 15, verse 11, where it says, you know, it's the whole I am the vine, branches thing that we talked about a couple of weeks ago. But essentially, the whole point of that is to give us a particular kind of joy that our hearts can overflow with. And that is the largest catalyst for actually sharing the gospel, actually sharing our faith. So how do we do that? How do we have this joy? Well, next week, we're going to talk about joy and thankfulness. Joy is one of those things that we don't often think about a lot, Or if we do, we sometimes have a few misconceptions, let's just put it that way. So we will have an exciting project for your kids that involves broccoli, not eating it, don't worry, but they'll hold it and make an art project, so that's gonna be pretty cool. All gearing up for Thanksgiving. Again, thanks for checking us out on YouTube. If you like these kinds of teachings, you can show up Family Discipleship 10 a.m. on Sunday mornings, First Presbyterian Church, downtown Bradenton. Church website, bradenton.church. It's very easy to be connected with this family of believers. Thanks, FPC family, for watching, subscribing, and sharing. We love you.